Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build the next iteration of my multi-floor realistic pop-up bunker elevator, this time with a direct level selection. This build is based on the previous iteration, which had a call function and multiple floors, but only allowed you to go one floor up or one floor down each time you press the button. This time you can actually select where you want to end up within those floors here. There is one little caveat, and that is that now the floor number is limited to 16 floors in total, since I'm using a lectern with a book and quill as an input. I was able to increase that to 16 by simply removing the current floor from the selection menu. So at the moment I'm at floor number 1, and as you can see I can select floor 2, 3, 4, and the rest of those pages here are completely empty. That's basically our selection. Now let's say I want to go to floor number 2. First I need to select the value or the floor in the lectern and then press the corresponding button. And after a little delay, which would also allow you to press the button and get in here, you can see that the floor or the elevator is now going to the second floor. So now I'm at floor number 2, and that's how this thing here works. Now if you are on a floor where the elevator isn't waiting for you, all you need to do is first look at the light or at the signal here and see that the elevator is waiting somewhere, and then press the button, and then we will call the elevator to this very floor, which you can see also with this second signal line. So that's those couple floors here. Now the topmost floor is slightly different, so let's go to number 4 here. And as you can see here, the topmost floor is completely flat, which doesn't allow for any real addition of a visible signal or a lectern selection panel at the top, which means that in case of the topmost part here, you can only select to go to the next lower floor. But besides of that, you can select on each floor where you want to end up with. And that's basically how this thing works. Now let's talk about the sizes. So in total, this build is 12 blocks long, at least at the very top. The bottom segments are 2 blocks slimmer. Then the entire thing is 18 blocks wide. And the height obviously depends on how you space your floors and how many floors you have in total. Now there are some limits to the distance between floors. Between this bottommost module and an intermediate station, it's 12 blocks. Between intermediate stations or two-way stations, it's 14 blocks. And between an intermediate station and the topmost station, it's 17 blocks. The topmost station, as you have seen before, is pretty much flat, besides of some buttons. And the bottommost station goes 5 blocks below the floor. Or 6 blocks, if you count the floor itself. And that's the entire sizes. Now let's talk about the required resources. So in this chest, I have put some required resources, and those are only the resources you need additionally to upgrade the previous version to this new version. Link for the tutorial of the previous version you can also find in the description. Anyway, what are you gonna need additionally to build this? Now for each floor, you're gonna need a couple building blocks, then 15 obsidian blocks, 7 snaps, half a stack of slime blocks, 2 redstone blocks, 30 redstone dust, 12 redstone torches, 15 repeaters and comparators, 11 observers, 5 node blocks, 13 sticky pistons, 2 hoppers, 2 lecterns, each with a book and quill, then a single composter with something to put in a single layer, then 2 chests, and additionally to interconnect those floors, roughly for every 13 blocks, you're gonna need 2 obsidian blocks, 42 snine blocks, 4 redstone blocks, 2 observers, 4 sticky pistons, and 2 node blocks. And that's pretty much all you're gonna need, so let's show you how to build this elevator here. Okay, so the first step is actually building the previous version of this build here. So the multi-floor elevator design where you had 2 buttons on each intermediate floor, where you could decide whether you want to go one floor up or one floor down. The link for the corresponding tutorial can find in the description. As a little heads up, that tutorial will also link you to a previous tutorial for the building of the bottommost and the topmost station. But anyway, once you have built this, the one thing you must make sure of is that you can actually call the elevator to each floor. So if the elevator is on a different floor and you press any of those buttons on any floor, the elevator must come up to your floor and stop there. And once you're sure that that works properly, it's time to start modifying or adding a circuit to the other side opposite of this interconnection between the floors to essentially implement a remote call function. And for that I will start with the bottom floor, then I will go to the top floor, and then I will talk about the intermediate floors. Okay, so for the bottom floor, the first step is actually calling the elevator to this very floor and then stopping it from moving anywhere else by placing a 2x2 of immovable blocks on top of the cabin, as you can see here. Then you can also place down your 2 lecterns on the side where the floors are not yet interconnected, so opposite to where they are interconnected. Inside of those lecterns, you place a book that has 15 pages in total and starts with the page for floor number 2, then 3, 4 and so on. And in this case, since I only have 4 floors in total, after page number 3, there are still pages in there, but they don't lead or they won't lead to any other floor. That way, since I'm leaving out the floor I'm currently on, I can actually work with up to 16 floors in total and not just 15 floors. And that's the first few steps. The next step is on the side where we have the lecterns. We need at least a 2-high gap for some parts of the circuitry. Then we need also a block on top of the lectern with a button to the side, which you can just take from the floor. And the same we need obviously on this side too. Then it's time to start modifying the previous version a bit. First, we don't need this button here, and we also don't need that part of the circuitry which would actually trigger the whole thing from the bottom here. So let's quickly remove the few blocks here, and then let's replace this with a normal block. The same on this side here, so let's remove that one, then those few blocks, the few blocks here, and then let's replace that redstone wire again. Then, when we're here, let's go and place a block right behind the lectern, and a torch on the back of the block with the button on it. Then we need another block down here with a comparator in this direction, which runs into a full block with some redstone dust on top. A block on top of the comparator here. Then place down 2 blocks like so, some redstone wire here, another comparator here on the subtract mode. Then we basically mirror this on this side here. After that, let's go down here, and first we need to remove this block here diagonally to the sticky piston there. Replace it with an observer looking in this direction here, put a node block to the front, and then place a full block inside of this corner there. Replace the redstone wire on top, then add 3 blocks in a row here, then go up a block, then towards the front another block up, then down, add another 2 blocks here, a raised block around this corner, and then 2 more raised blocks here. Cripple Peter placed here on one tick, then some redstone wire all the way over to this single block there. Then I'll repeat on 2 and on 4 ticks there. Put redstone dust on top of those 2 blocks. Then add another 2 blocks here. Put a repeat on 2 ticks there. With an obsidian block right behind it. Then on the front side here, place a block here with a comparator taking output from the bottom dropper. Run this into a full block with a torch to the side of it. Then diagonally to that we need a block with another 2 blocks to this side here. Put down the redstone wire, run this into a full block with a torch on the side of it. Then an obsidian block, another torch on the side, normal block, torch on the side, obsidian block on top, torch to the side, and this time also on top. Then let's go and quickly add another block next to this obsidian block here, with a repeat on one tick on top of it, a obsidian block behind that repeater, and some redstone wire on top. Then let's go back to those 2 comparators here. In front of this one here at the back, we need a raised block, then a lowered obsidian block. And here we need first a lowered normal block and then a raised obsidian block. Put down 2 redstone wire on those lowered blocks. Then we need a block here with a comparator in this direction running into a full block. With a lowered block down here. Add another block to this side. Then 3 blocks like so. A raised block here. Put down 2 redstone wire here, one there. Then a comparator here and another one here. Then we need a sticky piston facing downwards with a observer in this direction running into a full block. Then we need 2 lowered blocks towards the side, a raised block, lowered block, then a raised obsidian block and another raised normal block. Touch on top of this one here, then 2 redstone wire down there and 2 repeaters on 3 ticks each like so. Then let's go back to this part here with a block next to this redstone wire. Put some redstone dust on top. Then we need a sticky piston facing downwards next to the block. Full block below it, so when the block is extended, it will connect the repeater with the wire. Put another sticky piston on top with a observer facing sideways. Diagonal to that we need a lowered block and then a raised block. Put a repeater on 2 ticks inside of this gap with a torch to the side of that one. Then an observer on top of this torch. Grab 2 sticky pistons and place them like so, facing upwards, with slime blocks on top and in between an observer. Then go down, place a slime block next to this obsidian block here. Then an observer below that, which when it's pulled upwards will actually power the obsidian block. At the same height we need another slime block with a 1 wide gap next to this block with nothing on top. And now we basically just build up our 2 slime towers until we are roughly at the same height as our elevator cabin. And those 4 slime towers will later on be the connection between the different floors. I will leave them as they are at the moment, since how you will have to interconnect them depends a bit on the distance between the different floors. And with that we are pretty much finished with the bottom floor, which means now it's time to start building the top floor. Now for the top part, once more we start on this side here. We start roughly at the center, next to the block with the last of those 3 repeaters here. Put a block there, redstone dust on top and a torch to the side. Then go down 2 blocks with a block and place a torch on top of it, so this torch here is now turned off. Put a block here with a repeater on top on 4 ticks, connecting the torch with the redstone wire. Then, diving to this, we need a block down, another block on the same, and then 1 block up. Put a observer running into this block in this corner. Place a slime block below that. And then place down 2 repeaters on 3 ticks each, like so. Place another slime block like so, with a one white gap. Again, observer on top, block on top, and to the side. Then a repeater on 3 ticks there, with a sticky piston next to the block, block on top. Then place a hopper on top of this repeater here. And inside of this hopper, you place some items. Now the number of items depends on which floor in total this actually is. So in this case, I have this as the fourth floor. And that means that if I were to take an output with a comparator here, that comparator would produce a signal strength of 4. So a little insert here, one quick correction. The signal strength of the hopper here should be one less than the number of floors you have. So in this case, you need a signal strength of 3 if you have 4 floors. And if you have, for example, 16 floors, it would be 15. Otherwise, this will not work properly. Once you have figured that out, it's time to add another block here. Put a comparator there, so it can take an output if the sticky piston here is extended. Run this into a full block. Then we need a lowered block right here. With another lowered block here, then another 3 blocks here, so we get this 5 block shape here. Then above this gap we need a raised block. And above this corner also a raised block. Put down 2 redstone wire here and one there. A comparator running into this block, and another comparator in the opposite direction there. Then we need a sticky piston in this direction with another observer in front of it, running into a block on top of our hopper there. Next to that we need a block with a repeater on 2 ticks, running into a full block with a torch on the side of it, and then finally a full block on top, which basically connects the torch with this redstone wire there, which was the whole reason for that wire in the beginning. And that's once more the whole circuit for this floor done. As with the bottom floor from before, I will leave it as it is at the moment and will come back to the interconnecting part at a later point. So next up, it's time for the intermediate floors. For that, the first step is removing the actual selector panels. So let's quickly do that. Don't forget to remove also the redstone wire at those two positions there. Then we can actually fill in the rest of this wall, if we have already built that one, like so. Now we need to add on the side where we actually need our circuitry, once more our lectern with our book in there. Now since this here is the floor number 2, we have the first floor on the first page, and then on the second page we have already floor number 3. Then once more we need a 2 high gap to this side here, and obviously we need to mirror this once more. And on top of our lectern, obviously we need then the block with the button. Next, place a block behind the lectern and one block diagonally down. Put a torch behind the block with the button on it, and a comparator on top of this block there. Run this into a full block with some redstone dust on top, and another full block on top of the comparator there. Then an upside down step here, and a full block there. Put some redstone wire here, and a comparator in subtract mode here. Then quickly mirror this. So let's quickly mirror this. Like so, some redstone dust, then the block, upside down slip, block, redstone wire, and the comparator and subtract mode, like so. Then go to this front left corner here, and start by removing those 3 blocks here, and this block here. Then place a sticky piston in front of this powered redstone wire here. Or it should be at least powered when the door is closed. Put a full block to the face of it. Then place a normal block here. 2 upside down steps there. another normal block there, and then some redstone dust on top of those. Next, go to the back corner here, and add those last three blocks here. You go down a layer and place three blocks like so in a row. Then two blocks here and last one there. Then a raised one here. And here. Put some redstone wire here and there. Cut off the redstone wire at this position there. Then a comparator running into this block. And two in the opposite direction on the last two blocks. Then grab a chest, place it here. On top of the chest we need a hopper. And next to the hopper we need a normal block. Put redstone dust on top of the hopper. A repeater on three ticks on top of that block here. Then a steel piston right in front of the repeater facing downwards with a full block to the face. Then from this block we need to go down a layer with an obsidian block. Then up with a normal block, down with another obsidian block. Put a repeater on one tick in this gap, some redstone wire here, cut that off with another obsidian block. Then put a steel piston here with an observer facing upwards with a full block on top, torch on top of that one. Then let's go and take an output with a repeater on three ticks, run this into a full block with a block to the side, some redstone dust on top, another block to the side raised, and then a torch on top of that one. And while we're at this position here, let's actually add some items into this chest here. Now the amount of items, once more, depends on which floor you are on. If you are, in this case, on the second floor, you need to have a signal strength of 1. So basically, you take the number of the floor minus 1. Or the number of floors below this point. In this case, as I mentioned, 1. For the next floor it would be 2, and if we had another one, then 3 and so on. Following that, let's place a sticky piston diagonally to the chest, facing upwards. 2 further towards the front, another sticky piston. In between an obsidian block. And then below redstone blocks. If you have the minimum distance, you may have already the connection to the next lower floor, but that's not really important at this point. What is important that those two pistons are now extended. Now let's place at first three line blocks on top of each. Grab a few observers. Place one running into the lowest here, then another one going downwards in between the lowest two slime blocks, then another one going outwards here, and one on top of that. Then add another three to the columns, and add at the third from the top another observer facing downwards. Then let's go and add two blocks like so. Put a repeater on three ticks here and another one there. Run this into a full block. Then block on top of this torch here. Redstone dust on top. Torch here. Then a repeater on four ticks there, running into a full block like this here. Then place another torch on top of this block. Now grab an obsidian block and place it next to this first repeater here. Then a layer below that we need an obsidian step in this corner there. After that obsidian block we need a full block, then obsidian block, full block, then after this full block another raised block, torch on the side of that, block on top, torch on the side of that, block on top, redstone dust on top. Then place down 5 redstone wire here, make sure you don't accidentally place one here for now. Because now we need to place some blocks to cut off that wire here, here, and here. And then you can place your last two redstone wire here. Put one block here with a torch on top, block on top, torch on top, block on top. Then let's go and add another block here with a repeater on one tick in this direction. Nothing on top of this block, following that an obsidian block here, and then some more redstone dust on top of that one. Then place a full block next to this block up here. Put a sticky piston facing downwards next to that with an observer running into this direction, then a block diagonal to the observer next to this block here. Put a repeater on 2 ticks on top, then run this into a full block with a torch on top of it. Then to the side of that we need an upside down slab. Then raised blocks to those 2 sides here. Following that 2 obsidian blocks next to this 9 block. Then put down 3 redstone wire here. 2 repeaters on 1 tick each there. Then a full block in front of those 2 repeaters. Next we need a node block here below this block and 2 blocks further along the way. Then while we're there, let's place a hopper inside of this corner here with some redstone wire on top. Then a full block here, another full block there. Then grab some sticky pistons and place them below those 2 node blocks. Put at least 3 slime blocks below them. Then an observer facing upwards in between the top most of those slime blocks. And then an obsidian block in between those 2 sticky pistons here. The interconnection between those slime columns and those ones here we will do at a later point. Next, it's time to go back to our inputs. First, add a block in front of each of those 2 comparators here. Then we go down a layer and add 2 obsidian blocks in the center. Then put a comparator here, some redstone wire there. Then a lowered block around the corner there. Another comparator here. And then we have a raised block, lowered block around the corner, raised block, lowered block, like so. Put down 2 comparators, put this one here in the subtract mode, and place an upside down slab next to that with some redstone dust on top. Then a full block here with another comparator there. Then here, let's start by placing down 2 blocks like so. Some redstone dust here, and a repeat on 1 tick there. Then some redstone dust on top of this one here. Then a raised block on top of this comparator, on top of this one, and in front of this one, like so. Put down 2 repeaters on 1 tick each, like so. Then another block here with a comparator in the normal mode right there. Put a chest right behind the comparator. And here once more you put in enough items to get a signal strength out of the comparator that is 1 less than the number of this floor, or equal to the number of floors below. Then place a sticky piston diagonally to that comparator here. And now you should have exactly this space free here to place in a composter. And inside of this composter we need exactly 1 layer. Make sure this is exactly 1 layer. Then go back to the front here. First we need a block down here on top of this redstone repeater. Then add another block to the front and 3 blocks to this side here. Then a raised block around this corner. Put a comparator running into this block. Then another one in the opposite direction down. Then 3 redstone wire like so. Cut off the wire at this position. Add another block in front of this repeater there, node block next to that, then a sticky piston below that with an observer facing in this direction, running into a full block. Place down a block like so, put a repeater on 3 ticks running into another full block with some redstone dust on top. Then a block on top of the repeater, torch to the side of that one, some redstone dust on top of this one. Then grab an obsidian block and cut off the wire in this position. Put down a block in this gap there, and another repeater on 3 ticks running into this block there. Then grab some slime blocks. Place one on top of this block and one on top of this block right there. And then an observer right in the middle of those two. Obsidian block hovering above that with a one high gap. And then a sticky piston to either side. With a node block on top. And on top of that one, then a redstone block. So another little insert here, two quick corrections. On the front left side, down here we have this repeater on 3 ticks. This needs to be set to 2 ticks. And if you go to the back here, where you have the composter, you can go inside of this circuit here. And here we need to add a sticky piston below in the piston arm with the composter next to it, facing downwards with a full block below it. And we're almost finished. Last part is adding a sticky piston on top of those two normal blocks here. In between we need an obsidian block. Then put, for now at least, 2 slime blocks on top. And an observer facing downwards in the middle of the 2 bottom slime blocks. And that's pretty much all we need to add for this circuit here. Now I will quickly copy this one more time, and then we need to make one little modification, but only for the floor number 2. And voila! So now I have also built the 3rd floor, and if you have more than that, you can also already build the other floors. I also already corrected the amount of items inside of those 2 chests here. Make sure you don't forget that. And now it's time to modify this 2nd floor a bit. The reason for that is that the timing mechanism here is slightly too slow to deal with the selection of the 2nd floor. And the whole thing we need to add or to change is in this front corner here. So let's start by putting this repeater on 3 ticks and replacing this one here by some redstone dust. Remove this block here and turn this repeater over in this direction. Put a obsidian block here and a full block where you had that sticky piston. Then remove this observer here. And this block with the redstone wire. Add 2 redstone wire here. And we are already finished with this modification there. So now that we have the required circuits added to the floors, it's time to actually interconnect them. And here you will most likely run into the pushing limits of the pistons, which means that you need some kind of repeating mechanism. And those 2 possibilities you can see here. So you have essentially a pair that is powering downwards of signal lines and another pair of signal lines that is powering upwards. For the downwards, you simply go with the power source, which is usually a redstone block, below that a node block, then a sticky piston, then a slime block. This you have 2x. Then in between the sticky pistons you have an obsidian block, and in between the topmost slime blocks here you have 1 observer, which when the thing retracts will also power those sticky pistons once. For the powering upwards you have the same setup, just flipped over without the node blocks. Another thing to keep in mind besides of the pushing limit is that you must make sure that you don't accidentally power anything down here. So since those slime columns here will retract twice or will retract upwards, you must make sure that you don't place a redstone block here or here. So the earliest way you can place a redstone block is in those positions. Now, as you can see, this will most likely go over the pushing limit if you go to the bottom there. So we will need to add 1 such module. So let's quickly do this. And as you can see, there is no real issue with adding that in between here. And now we have already connected the bottom floor with the next layer here. Now let's quickly do this at the very top. Here it's actually even simpler. In this case, it even, due to the fact that I had the minimum distance, fit quite nicely in there, so I didn't have to add anything here. But, interesting enough, since we don't have a lectern up here, we don't need the downwards lines. So you can remove actually those slime blocks here, the observer, and pretty much the entire signal line up to this point here. And now the last part is obviously connecting those two floors. And then once you are done with that, it's time to remove those obsidian blocks from the cabin and let's then try out if everything works properly. And voila. So now as you can see, everything is connected up. I already tested if the call and remote call or level selection worked properly, which they did. And, well, the last part, after you have made sure that everything is working, is obviously beautifying the entire thing a bit by at least hiding the redstone circuitry within a few walls. And that's basically how you can build this multi-floor bunk elevator with a direct level selection. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and, well, see ya!